session po, no, ng recording sa accounts ng Google Meet. So I had to download or add an extension dito kay Chrome para makapag ano po, nang makapag-record. Anyway, this recording and yung presentation po na gagamitin ko, I'll be providing you the links to access them. Siyempre, para din po sa benefit ninyo, especially with how I want the essay responses or how the essay questions after the class to be answered. Okay, nabigay na natin yan or nabanggit na natin yan during the orientation. Speaking of the orientation, for those that haven't or were not able to join the orientation 2 weeks ago, the slides and the recording of that orientation is available sa Google Classroom natin if you haven't seen it. Okay. Another thing is, aside from the essay question I'll be giving for out today, you will also be answering your first midterm quiz later na naka-based sa orientation po natin. So all the questions would be based on the orientation. So if you need a review, again, the recording for the orientation and the slides are available as well. Okay? We'll begin with attendance monitoring muna, as mentioned. Medyo mahirap nga lang tong si attendance monitoring ko as ang problema with here in Google Meet, yung lists po ng students or attendees are alphabetically arranged siya pero by first name. Tapos medyo depende pa sa ano, may iba-iba ng pagkakalagay. Merong first name ang nakalagay, may last name. Anyway, I'll fix this up. Kung ano yung arrangement na makikita ko rito, ganito ko ilalagay din siya sa attendance na gagawin ko next time para mas smooth yung transition po ng pag-check po ng attendance niyo. Although there may automated checking din naman ako ng attendance right here. I just want to be sure that I am able to catch your attention, that I am indeed checking your attendance religiously po. Okay? As I should. So just a moment lang po. Hahanapin ko lang naman usually yung mga hindi ko makita dito sa list ko and then dito sa list ng list of people attending right now. So just a moment, no? Cruzado, really Ablasa, ayan, kita ko po sila. Reveresa, Ramos, and Soriano. Is Ramos and Soriano around? Ardell?
Yes, Ramos po present.
Okay. How about Ari Soriano? Ari Soriano po, wala? Okay, so second straight absent na po ni Mr. Soriano. Pakisabihan po ito. Okay, and sa orientation po natin, umabot po ng apat na unexcused, it would already be tagged as unexcused absences po. Nasa list na po siya ng pangalan ever since we started the class. Moving forward, scroll down ko lang po ito, just a moment. Walo, Corpus Munda, kita ko po yung tatlo, followed by Raka, Cornejo, and Pelias, andito naman po. De Leon, Romero, Antuano. Fitzgerald, nandiyan ka ba?
Yes po, sir.
Okay, sige. Next, let's have... I-scroll down ko yung list. Mendaño, Rada, Legarde. Okay, yan po yung tatlo. Panganiban, Valencia, Gakusan. Okay. Cruz, Apuyan, Bustamante. Okay din po. Moving forward. So, in-arrange ko yung ano ninyo, attendance ninyo. Alphabetically arranged para first name. Kaya baka magtataka kayo kung bakit ganun talon-talon yung ano ko. At meron din kasi iba sa inyo, hindi rin naman nila kasalanan. Unfortunately, yung last name ang nakalagay una bago yung first name. Kaya may mga hinahanap-hanap pa din ako. Gatbonton, Abatay, Borromeo. Borromeo, are you around, John Lloyd? Borromeo po. So wala po si Borromeo ha. Anyway, i-ano naman natin ulit later. Rioner, Lumacang, Lanuevo, Oli here. Masangkay, Arenal, Susan. Okay. Scroll down lang ulit. Yander. Dali ah. Nawala yung list ko. Ayun. Yander, Ventura, Palomeras. Miss Ventura, andito po ba?
Andito, sir.
Okay, sige. Yeah, last name yata yung pagkaka-arrange nung kay Miss Ventura. Next is Palomeras, Reyes, Fortaleza. Kita ko po yung tatlo. Alano, Mauna, Pasilyao. Okay. Alavanzas, Austria, Destua. Okay po, nandito. Followed by, scroll down lang, Destua, Aranas, Gumiran. Lina, are you in? Andyan po ba si Miss Aranas? Wala po. Next, we have Zelda, Navasca, Alarcon. Okay. And then finally, we have San Gabriel. Rina. Okay, nandyan din po. Verify ko lang ulit yung hindi ko na, ano ha, hindi ko nakita sa list and hindi rin sumagot. Aranas, Borromeo, Soriano. Last call po. Para dun sa tatlo. Nakatag na to as an excuse absent po. Okay, sige po. That's it. Let me just go ahead and share yung ating first lesson for the day. Anyway, from this meeting forward, we will be using Google Meet already. Okay? So, ano lang po tayo, okay? Unless otherwise stated, kung sakali mag-down si Google Meet for some reason, that would be the time that we will be using other forms of makabalik tayo ng MS Teams temporarily. Okay? But kung wala namang problema, Google Meet tayo from this point forward. So yung discussion po natin today would actually, yung discussion natin ng robotics would actually begin with a brief history, or mag-umpisa tayo with the definition, no, of robotics and robots. Then we look at some early history of robots. Okay? Pero yung mga robots sa pag-uusapan natin doon are technically not robots yet. They're automatons. You'll learn why they're not, hindi sila papasa as robots, no, sa definition. The third part will be looking into some modern robots or industrial robots created starting in the end of the 19 or the World War II, the 1950s, 60s up to the early 90s. And finally, we'll be talking about the laws of robotics as presented or as described by Isaac Asimov. Share lang po muna natin yung ating ano. Okay. So let us begin with, as mentioned, a brief history of robotics. Okay. So first and foremost, let us define a robot muna. Okay. Anong nga po ba ang isang robot? So we will be looking at some several definitions po of a robot according to several sources. Okay? So according to the Robot Institute of America, so medyo mahaba and detailed yung definition niya ng robot. Himay-himayin natin ng konti para mas maintindihan natin. So according to that organization, robots are a reprogrammable multifunctional manipulator. So let's look at that first statement. So according to their definition, a robot should be reprogrammable. Sabihin, we can program a robot initially, but there should be a way to change its movements, its actions, okay, by doing a reprogram. Ibig sabihin, hindi lang dapat isang beses natin siya mapoprogram. So there should be a way to change and to reprogram it. Okay? Now, a robot is also a multifunctional manipulator. Multifunctional, ibig sabihin lang that robots have different types, having different functions. Okay? So, hindi naman ibig sabihin na isang robot would have many functions. Usually, may mga robots tayo individually na maraming functions. But we also have robots that have only one specific function. Yung sinasabi nitong multifunctional is robots in general or as a whole. So, ang robots, marami po siyang applications, maraming movement na pwedeng gawin, marami pong tasks that it can actually do. Okay? Saan papasok yung word na manipulator? So, in a sense, yung sinasabi po na manipulator dyan is that robots are able to actually manipulate, quote-unquote, physical objects. Okay? So, kumbaga, itong mga robots natin have some way of being able to change the location of a physical object. No? I-pick and place niya, di ba? Bubuhatin niya yung isang bagay, then ililipat niya. Pwedeng nakakagalaw siya or nakakagamit siya ng iba't ibang device, no, to be able to perform its tasks. So yun po yung ano natin sa manipulator. And its design, dito papasok pa rin yung manipulator natin. So yung mga usual applications niya, it is able to move materials, move parts, tools, or specialized devices. Okay? So nabanggit na natin, 'di ba, yung mga usual functions ni robot, nakakapag change ng different or nakakapag move ng mga materials, parts ng kotse or parts ng isang product in a factory. But aside from manipulating these objects, robots could also have tools incorporated into them, not just tools, but specialized equipment and devices, no, like mga panghinang, pang welding, pang spray paint, no, so on and so forth. Okay. And this is done through various programmed motions. So nabanggit na natin that robots are programmable, not just programmable, but also reprogrammable. So, lahat ng actions niya has to be put in to the robot. Okay? And as much as possible, wala dapat manual control. Although there are specific robots na manual ang control, pero yung connections nila, hindi technically, physically natin kinokontrol yung robot. Kasi baka sabihin nyo, sir, pag manual control, hindi na siya robot. So, for example, meron akong device na kinokontrol ko using a remote control or a sort of joystick, hindi na ba siya robot? May mga specific pa rin kasi tayong tinitignan na criteria para masabi yon. Okay? But in most cases, robots should have their movements already programmed into it. Okay? Now, the reason for programming these motions is for the performance of a variety of tasks. So, mga gawain na marami. Okay? Actually, dun papasok na yung term natin na multifunctional. We've already learned that they are already multifunctional to begin with, right? So, if we're going to base it on the definition of one of the famous dictionaries that we have, Webster's Dictionary, robots are an automatic device. So when we talk about automatic, dapat free na siya manual control. its movement should be decided upon by the robot itself or by its programming. So this automatic device performs functions, which we've mentioned already with the first definition, gumagalaw-galaw po siya, okay? And it moves normally as functions normally ascribed to humans or machines in the form of a human. So more or less, ang sinasabi ni Webster's Dictionary, yung galaw po ng robot was actually designed or was created with the human movement in mind. Okay? So kumbaga parang eventually we created these robots so it would do movements that humans would do. And then eventually it would replace the movement of the human or humans themselves in a variety of work or tasks. The British Department of Industry defines a robot, actually very short term lang to, and nabanggit na to kanina sa definition ng Robot Institute of America. So the British Department of Industry defines a robot as a reprogrammable manipulator device. Okay? So natin yan, we won't go deeply into that. Let's try to define na lang robotics. So in its simplest, robotics is a study of the design, movement, construction, programming of robots, right? It's a study of robots, to be exact. Now, in this definition by Mike Brady, medyo nilaliman niya yung definition niya ng robotics, okay? Kasi nabanggit natin with the Webster's Dictionary definition that robots were created in order to mimic human movement and eventually replace them into some specific functions. Okay? So that would mean that para magaya natin, okay, yung galaw ng robot when we're creating them, we must look into how humans and even how animals functions or work. Normally, when we do actions, no, some actions are involuntary or automatic, like breathing, heartbeats, right? Yung iba, subconscious na lang natin ginagawa, hindi na natin pinag-iisipan, like walking and other stuff. Some actions are deliberate, meaning pinag-isipan talaga natin gawin. Okay? But in most cases, no, dun sa mga examples natin ngayon, actions done by humans is due to correlation or rather yung pagtutulong-tulong ng mga systems in the human body. Specifically, our nervous system, muscular and skeletal system. Okay? So if we want to grab an object, okay, our brain would control our muscles to control our arms and fingers to grab that object. We'll use our eyes, okay, and our sense of touch to make sure that we're holding into that object firmly but not too strong as if would break the object. Okay? So, kumbaga, may sense of perception combined with the brain and the transfer of the information sa nervous system in order to create that action. And that is how Mike Brady defined robotics. Paano ba natin ilalapat, okay, yung paggawa ng robot? And that is done by actually recreating yung action na yun, no? Yung perception, then nervous system, then action. Okay? So that is how robotics was defined by the word robot actually first appeared in a play created by Carl Capek in the 1920s entitled R.U.R. or otherwise known as Rosom's Universal Robots. So in this science fiction play created by Carl Capek, a character in the play tried simplifying the human anatomy such that it would be able to apply it into machines. Okay? So, sinimplify niya yung tao, yung anatomy niya, that would include all the systems, the brain, the nervous system, skeletal, lahat. Okay? Kasi the human system is very, very complex. It's very, very hard to, or almost impossible to recreate. So, what we can do is actually try simplifying it as what is done by that character in the play and created machines based on that simplified design, no, ng anatomy ng tao, creating robots. Now, in the play, robots there were created as a replacement for human workers. Okay? Marami kasing advantages si robots compared to humans as employees. Kaya lang, just like with most science fiction novels, plays, and stories na ang focus is robotics, eventually, the robots gained sentience and self-awareness. Sabihin, nagkaroon ng pagkakakilanlan, no, sa sarili niya, self-awareness. And was able to join with other robots and revolt against their human masters. Okay? Now, the robot itself that was coined there came from the word robota. So, robota is a Czechoslovakian term for worker. Right? Robota is also the word used for the term serf, S-E-R-F. Which is a highfalutin term or a complicated term that means a peasant, a pisante, okay, or dukha, something like that. So, after this definition, let us now move forward with the early conceptions of robots. Okay? So, nabanggit ko kanina, ito kasi mga, ano pati, ancient times and medieval times that are quite close to what a robot is, or what an android or humanoid robot is. Okay? Kaya lang, hindi natin kasi sila pwedeng tawagin as true robots. Okay? Kasi pag robots, technically, aside from the definitions we have mentioned a while ago, kailangan, ano rin sila, no? Electronic device. They should be digital. Okay? Meron dapat siyang some form of microprocessor or microcontroller. Okay? Para mag-function siya. And it must be powered, or yung energy niya would come from mainly electricity. So if you look at the robots here, karamihan dyan, or all of them, sa early conceptions of robots, were purely mechanical. Wala tayong makikita dyan that work due to electricity. Okay? So we cannot classify them as true robots. So kaya ang mas correct na term para sa kanila is automatons or automata. Okay? So the earliest concept of a mechanical device na parang robot or an automata appeared in ancient Egypt, okay, around 3000 BC. So the main way of telling time during those times was using the water clock. Normally, dalawa lang naman ang ginagamit for telling time in the ancient times. The sundial and the water clock. Ang problema with the sundial kasi is that it is very reliant on the sun, of course. So kung pag cloudy or rainy days, it wouldn't work. Another problem with the sun or using the sun as your main way of telling time, okay, is that the length of day varies from season to season. Diba? During winter time, or sa atin, November, December, January, maiksi ang araw, diba? Mahaba ang gabi. So kahit 6:30 na, o kaya alas 5 pa lang ng hapon, madilim na. But during summertime, it's the opposite. Mahaba ang araw, maiksi ang gabi. Okay? So, ang mas reliable na ginagamit nila is the water clock. So, sa water clock, they have a vessel like a drum that is filled with water na pinapatulo na parang gripo at a constant rate. Pwedeng patak-patak or pwedeng constant stream of water. Depende sa lalim nung tubig na bumuhos, okay, or nawala doon sa main na tangke, malalaman nyo kung ilang oras na yung lumipas. Okay? Now, one of the things that is different from the water clock here in Egypt is there are water clocks na merong humanoid figure sa ibabaw, okay, na nag-i-strike ng bell kapag lumipas na ang isang oras. Now, just like our modern clocks, diba? May mga orasan tayo na kapag pumatak ang isang oras, no? Pag alas dos, mag-a-alarm. Alas tres, tutunog din, so on and so forth. Okay? So yun yung parang ginawa nila na automaton during 3000 BC. In 400 BC, Archytus of Tarentum. Okay? Archytus of Tarentum is quite a prolific inventor, very important inventor as well. Siya nag-imbento ng pulley and screw. Those are two very important simple machines. Without them, we won't be able to create our more modern machines. Actually created several automatas. But the most famous automaton na ginawa niya is a wooden pigeon. Okay? Or it is kahoy in the shape ng kalapate. Okay? Na may machinery sa loob and allows it to move. And according to historical papers, it was also able to fly. Okay? And yung motions niya is primarily due to mechanical action. Going back to Egypt at a later time, they were able to create bigger automata or automata ng humanoid figures that could actually move. Not move, na they are staying in the same location, but rather they can move their arms, their head, and even their mouth. So sa nakakapagsalita daw yun, o nakakapagsabi ng prophecy or propesya, pero of course, yung salita naman nun, most probably, may tao lang sa loob. Okay? Or sa likod, that acts as a voice. Pero gumagalaw yung bibig, na parang kunwari yung statue na yon yung nagsasalita. Now, there was also automata, no, that was used in warfare. So we have the claw. Parang ito yung ninuno or ancestor of the industrial robotic arm, which is found in modern factories. Yun naman makikita nyo sa mga factories ngayon, assembly plants, karamihan ng robots nila are robotic arms. Okay? So itong si Daklo is a big arm that can actually hold on to ships, grab ships, at ginagamit siya para ibaligtad yung mga sasakyang pandagat. Makahoy lang naman gawa yung mga yon. I don't know if it malamang it can only handle smaller ships. So may size limit lang sa mga sa size ng ships na pwedeng niyang galawin. Okay? So yun po yung silbi ni Daklo. So the Greek inventor Philon of Byzantium, okay, who died around 220 BC, okay, created like a domestic automata, okay, in the figure of a human, na ang ginagawa is naghahalo sa isang kamay, meron siyang wine. Then sa isang kamay, meron siyang cup of water. So ang ginagawa nitong automata na to is it actually mixes wine with water. Okay? I don't know why they do that. Baka it's a practice before to dilute wine with water para bumaba ang alcohol content. Okay? Pero yun lang yung ginagawa nung invention na yun. Also known as, hindi lang siya tinatawag na mekaniko, sinatawag din siyang maid servant of Philon. Next, we have Hero or Heron of Alexandria, who actually created a programmable automata. Okay? Kasi lahat naman nung previously na nakita nating automata dito were not programmable. They were fixed movement in nature. So si Hero was able to create an automata. So may cart, para siyang kariton na malaki na pwedeng itulak. May machinery sa loob. Then sa ibabaw, doon yung automata niya, yun yung nakikitang gumagalaw. Okay? So napapagalaw niya yung automata niya, as shown in the figure. May mga ropes tayo na nakatali sa axle. Ito, umiikot tong si O sa kasi P. Before actually coming into a pulley, and then sa dulo may naka-attach na weight o bigat. Habang umiikot ito, itong ating axles. Okay, it would affect the mukha naman yung ginagawa ng automata sa ibabaw. Ngayon, paano ito na po program? So, pwede mong baguhin yung movement ng automata sa ng part, the rope. So, yung mga tali na nakapalibot dito na nakikita nyo, okay, pag pinahabaan mo siya or iniksian, it would actually change how the automata above would work or take action. So in a sense, parang pwede mong i-reprogram yung galaw nila by changing the length of the rope. Siyempre, we have Leonardo da Vinci, a very prolific inventor, designer, a renaissance man, no? Kasi dami niyang pwede kayang gawin. Painter, okay? Scientist, so on and so forth, actually created the design of its own automata. So itong automata na to is a knight na nakakaupo, nakakatayo on its place, and is able to iangat or ibaba yung visor ng kanyang helmet. So naka full plate armor kasi ito, diba, kung mapapansin nyo. Then, yung helmet niya, parang sa helmet ng motor, may visor na pwedeng iangat ibaba. So, yung automata ni Da Vinci can actually do that. Okay? Kaya lang, it's unknown if Da Vinci actually or was able to create that design into reality. Ang nakita lang kasi were the design in paper. At yung nakikita nyo na picture dito is just a recreation of the vision of Da Vinci doon sa design niya. Okay, so this is not the actual automata na ginawa ni Da Vinci. Okay. The best automata makers are actually the best clock makers in ancient times. Kasi ang mga orasan will also purely mechanical but could tell time. Napaka-intricate and complex ng movements ng orasan. Okay? So with that knowledge, they were also able to apply that knowledge of clocks into creating their own automata. So one such clock maker is the Italian Gianello Torriano, who actually created several automata to cheer up or to entertain his king. Okay. One of the famous automata na ginawa niya is called the praying monk. So itong praying monk na to would just move paikot-ikot. Pero hindi siya circle, parang pa-square. So, move siya straight, liliko, move straight, liliko, move straight, liliko. And it would go back to its original position. Aside from that, while moving in a square-like pattern, it is also able to move its hands. Kasi yung kamay niya may hawak na rosario and Bible or cross rather. And while it's moving, inaangat-angat niya yung rosario. Tapos yung kamay niya ay yung ulo niya bumababa taas din, no? Na parang in conjunction ng pag inangat niya yung rosario, parang hinahalikan niya yung rosario. Then titingala siya na parang nagdadasal kasi pati yung bibig niya bumubuka while it's moving in that pattern. Okay? So syempre, pag sinabi nating robots, hindi natin maaalis ang Japan, Jaan. Kasi they're one of the advanced in robotics. Okay? And even during the 1600s, they also have their own version of the automata, which is called the Karakuri Ninyo. No? Roughly translated to mechanical dolls. Yun yung ibig sabihin niya in English. So there were several types of Karakuri Ninyos. Okay, shown here is Zashiki Karakuri, which is used to serve tea to guests. So naglalakad dyan, may hawak na bowl ng tsaa, and it is able to serve tea to guests. May mga Karakuri Ninyo din or mechanical dolls that were used as performers for ancient myths or legends. Kumbaga parang palabas, instead of puppets, instead of tao, they use mechanical dolls to act out scenes. Okay? In the myths during festivals. One of the more or most impressive automata was that created by Jacques de Vaucanson. So he was able to create an automata that could play the flute. Okay? So, totoong flute, yung piniplay niya. So yung automata na to na ginawa ni Jacques could actually blow air, lumalabas sa bibig, then papasok sa flute, and then the fingers of the automata can actually move to cover the holes in the flute. Diba? Ganun naman ang pagpapatugtog ng flute. You blow into the flute, depending on which holes you actually put your fingers onto, it would give you a different tone or note. Okay? And imagine how hard it is to learn how to play the flute and Jacques de Vaucanson was able to. Another watchmaker, Pierre Jacquet Ross from Switzerland, created an automata, appropriately named the writer. So itong robot na to or not robot, itong automata na to really write words, sentences and phrases as long as it is within 40 characters long. Okay. And it is reprogrammable. Jack, or ni Pierre pala, rather, could you, it is possible to change kung ano yung sinusulat niya, okay, by arranging yung mechanical device niya sa loob. Aside from writing, sinasawsaw din niya yung quill, so ito yung ginagamit na panulat nung araw, sinasawsaw din niya yan sa tinta to be able to write. Okay? And then another watchmaker, another Swiss watchmaker, Henry Maillardet. Okay? Kung merong robot or automata na nagsusulat, ito namang ginawa ni Henry Maillardet, created an automata that could draw. So it's an automata na nakakapag-drawing po. Okay? In under 3 minutes. I'm just not sure kung reprogrammable yung nag-drawing niya. Okay? So yun po yung mga automata natin. Lahat po yan are purely mechanical and hindi po siya gumagana with electricity. So let's now move forward with our first modern robots. Okay? So ito mga robots na to, so ito pwede na nating tawagin as robots kasi as per definition na nabanggit natin kanina, they are also digital. Okay? And it uses electronic equipment and functions, and it is able to or get its power from electricity. So the first digitally operated and programmable robot was created by George Devol in 1954. Okay? At yun yung tinatawag na Unimate, isa sa mga pinakaunang robotic arm. So George Devol actually was able to sell Unimate to GM or General Motors. General Motors is a car company in the United States. So pinakatrabaho or ginagawa ng Unimate doon is it is able to lift hot pieces of metal and place it on a cooling liquid. Siyempre, ang mga kotse gawa sa bakal and para mahugis siya sa tamang hugis, yung ibang parts pinapanday. Sabihin, pinapainit, maaaring nilalagay sa molde. Diba? Pag pinainit yun ng, at high temperatures, it would turn into a liquid. Okay? And then ilalagay sa molde. Then eventually, it would harden. Kaya lang it would still be very hot, pero kailangan ng palamigin. So, inilalagay siya sa liquid, usually sa tubig, para lumamig. And that is traditionally done by humans. So, GM created a robot to do that function. Yung paglalagay na yon ng mainit na bakal into a cooling liquid. A mechanical engineering student, Victor Scheinman, no, created the Stanford arm. And it is actually recognized as the first electronic computer-controlled robotic arm. Okay? Yung robotic arm kasi na si Unimate, okay, yung programming kasi niyan was done directly doon sa robot. So if you want to change its functions, we have to stop the robot first. We will open it up, then change its programming. So itong ginawa ni Victor was a robotic arm na ang controls and programming is not within the robot itself, but it is with another device or another computer. So we can change its movements and actions so we don't have to open up the robotic arm physically. We can change the programming through the computer. Okay? Maganda yung nabanggit dito, mechanical engineering, kasi technically, if we're going to be or we're going to focus in the future as someone who will be building and designing robots, okay, maganda siya kay computer engineering kasi una, we're supposed to have the electronics knowledge and we also have the programming knowledge, which is very important with creating robots. Ang problema lang natin, we don't have the knowledge or the necessary knowledge of moving parts. So robots are still machines with moving parts. May mga motor, may mga gears, may mga physically moving parts siya. And we don't have a subject to teach us the specifics of how that would work. At yun ang pinag-aaralan naman sa mechanical engineering. They work on engines, on heat, thermodynamics, and machines. Mga moving parts, no? So on and so forth. Kaya lang, ang kakulangan naman nila, wala naman silang knowledge on electronics and programming. Okay? So kumbaga, complement yung knowledge ng mechanical engineering and computer engineering when it comes to robotics. So combining the two disciplines that we are able to become a good robotics expert. So the first mobile robot created, kasi yung si Unimate and the Stanford arm were static. Ibig sabihin, kung saan sila nakapwesto, dun lang sila nakastay. Pero may gumagalaw silang kamay, right? So the first ever created robot na nakakagalaw, well, that's why it's a mobile robot, is Shaky, which was created by the Stanford Research Institute in the 1970s. So nakakagalaw siya, and it's able to track its surroundings. Kasi hindi lang siya basta nakakagalaw, it can actually avoid obstacles and move into a different location. So may mga sensors siyang TV cameras, range finders, and bump sensors to be able to avoid obstacles and move a different path. Tinatawag siyang, gumagalaw siya, nanginginig talaga yung buong machine or system. Kaya siya binigyan ng palayaw na Shaky. So the first full-scale humanoid robot, kasi mga robots na nabanggit natin were just arms or were just any other shapes. Pero eventually, we wanted to look like human or in the form of a human being. So Waseda University in Japan initiated the WABOT project in 1967. And after 5 years, create, meaning, kasing laki talaga ng tao, no? Na humanoid intelligent robot, which is called WABOT 1. In the picture, it's not WABOT 1, it's already WABOT 2, right? Pero si WABOT robot or humanoid robot na ginawa. SCALA, or Selective Compliance Assembly robot arm, wasmotic arm. Pero ang pinaka specialization is specific function na to, pick and place. Sabihin, magaling si SCALA bumunot or kumuha ng the material, then place it. The Unimate and the Stanford arm and robotic arms could actually still do that. Hindi ganon ka-efficient or kasing bilis ni SCALA. Okay? So, yung mga robotic arms, sana, ding or painting. Okay? Pero in most, ano kasi, in most factories, aside from doing those functions. So marami ring parts doon na pick and place. May kukunin, ipalagay sa ibang lugar. And SCALA was created to do specifically that. So it's way, way better and much worse as compared to the normal so masyadong mahal, masyadong bulky yung mga sinaunang SCALA robot, ay yung mga sinaunang robotic arms like Unimate and Stanford Arm. So, Scamaster. Right? Ang disadvantage lang, yun lang ang kaya niyang gawin. Okay? Pick and play. So, in 9 to 10 years, or 20 years, noon na nag-conceptually ng kanyang humanoid robot, Honda, a car manufacturer, motorcycle manufacturer from Japan, okay, also started its own robot research and development, or humanoid robot research and development, which eventually became what is now known as ASIMO. So, we will now be moving forward into the laws of robotics. Okay? So, natapos natin yung mga modern, well, not the modern robots, but they are the start or the beginning of the industrial robots. Eventually, we will be creating robots na ipapartner with artificial intelligence. So, this would be intelligent androids or robots that would perform and create decisions and functions as well. Now, Isaac Asimov is a science fiction writer. Okay? Na usually, yung kanyang mga novels or stories involves robot. One of the more famous na kinreate niya is the Three Laws of Robotics. Okay? So, sa universe na ginawa ni Isaac Asimov sa mga novels niya and short stories, the intelligent robots are governed by three specific laws. Sabihin, they are like robots that functions as humans, but meron siyang mga specific na directives na kailangan sundin. So, yung una is that, by the way, this is arranged in most important or highest law to the least law. So, yung pinakaunang law dito, yung pinaka-importante. Okay? So, the first law states that a robot may not harm a human or through inaction allow a human to come to harm. So, sinasabi dito sa law na to is that a robot, well, basically, hindi siya pwedeng manakit ng tao. No? Hindi siya pwedeng pumatay. Okay? It should not do actions that would lead to a human getting hurt. Okay? But besides that, a robot must also must do everything in its power to make sure humans are safe. Sabihin, if there's a robot, may nakita siyang masasagasaan, malulunod, o mauhulugan ng bagay sa ibabaw, robots should do everything in its power to save that human, to save it from getting hurt or even getting killed. The second law states that a robot must always follow its or orders coming from human beings or from their owners. Except if it would come into conflict with the first law. So basically, whatever you tell a robot, wala siyang magagawa but to follow it. Except, pwede lang if that order would lead to conflicting or disregarding the first law. So basically, you can't tell in Isaac Asimov's world, okay, or universe. So hindi mo, di ka pwede tumuto sa robot na manakit, pumatay, na so on and so forth. The third law, the lowest law, the three, is a robot. Now, this is a law of self-preservation. A robot must protect its own existence. Okay? Okay? Ibig sabihin, hindi niya dapat hayaang kung may, let's say, may sunog sa isang bahay, kahit di siya dapat utusan ng kanyang tao or ng human owner niya na lumabas, it should protect its own existence. Yung robot, kapag may biglang flood, okay, or mayroong, you know, baha, so it should move automatically to a higher place para hindi siya maanod at mamasira. Okay? Except if it is in conflict in the first or second law. So if a human being tells a robot to go jump into a river, jump off a cliff, okay, go into a burning house, it must follow it. Pag sinabi ng tao mag-self-destruct siya, the second law will take precedence. Or, di naman kaya, tipong, di ba, yung first law, binanggit natin that it would sacrifice itself to save a human, yun ang priority niya. So, hindi self-preservation ang priority, but to save a human being from injury or death, and also sa orders ng humans. Eventually, through other court law, which is the highest among the first three. So, this is called the zeroth law. No? Kasi, pag yung mas mataas, yun yung mas, ano eh, mas importante. So, naglagay siya ng law na mas mataas sa first law, zeroth law. Kasi it's similar to the first law, but instead of human or humans, no, ibig sabihin, hindi lang tao or group of people, ang nakalagay dito is humanity, sangkatao, not harm humanity, or by inaction, allow humanity to come into harm, which is much, much higher. So, ang nagiging mat is to save humanity as a whole. And that would actually go into several problems. Like what? What if a human being would be the cause of isang tao or group of people the world or human? Robots can violate the first law. Kasi the lives of you is lower compared to that of humanity as a whole. Right? By the way, this in the universe of the novels na kinreate ni Isaac Asimov. Pero ito rin ang ginagamit o ginagawang template when going to create intelligent robots with AI. Hindi naman ang misconception kasi is kapag gumawa tayo ng robot na matalino, it would automatically follow these laws. Hindi. The laws have to be programmed into them. Kapag di mo naman pinrogram to, kunwari gumawa tayo ng robot na matalino, hindi mo naman to pinrogram sa kanya, it would not follow these laws kasi it was not programmed na sundin to ng robot. So this is like an ethical or moral template na gagamitin ng mga roboticists or robot creators and designers when eventually they would create an intelligent robot. So ito yung parang gagamitin nila na batayan. At dapat we have to program intelligent robots to follow these laws eventually. Or else we would have problems in the future. Parang ganun. So that would end our discussion for the day. Before we end today's discussion, again, I will be sharing the link to this presentation and to this recording sa Google Class ninyo. May ibibigay po ako sa inyong dalawang activity. Isa, yung quiz po na tungkol dun sa orientation na ginawa natin 2 weeks ago. Kung nakalimutan na, the slides and the recording of the orientation ay nandun po sa Google Class natin. Wala namang deadline itong quiz na to kasi parang bonus quiz lang naman siya. Okay? So you can answer it anytime. Pero syempre, bago sana mag-midterm, masagutan nyo na po. Yung quiz na to cannot be accessed kung hindi po RTU account ang gamit nyo sa Google. Google Classroom account to access them. Pangalawa, may essay question tayo na sasagutin based on today's discussion. Ang deadline po, up until before midnight tonight. Yung usual na case natin. Okay? As always, kapag di po tayo nagpaalam na malilate tayo sa pagpasa, hindi ko po ito gigradean. Okay? Pero usually kapag few minutes lang naman, kunwari, na-late ka, albang alas 12, 12.03, 12.05, tinatanggap ko na yan yung mga ganong kaso. Pero kapag kinabukasan na, kaya alas 2 na ng madaling araw, alauna, hindi ko na tinatanggap yan. Ibig sabihin, masyado ka nang late. So, wag na kayo magpakapuyat. Kung tingin nyo, hindi naman kayo aabot, magpaalam na lang kayo through the comments or all the channels, communication channels na binanggit ko sa inyo. Okay? So, yung mga absent ngayon, na hindi rin nakapagpaalam, wala naman nagpaalam sa aking absent or malilate, hindi rin gumawa nung ating activity. Okay, nabanggit na rin natin ang orientation yan. Okay? Please come on time. May grace period na tayong 15 minutes. I 45. Kung pangalawa, sir, may pagka-problema po kung ganito, ganito, ganyan. Usual excuse. Again, you're totally free bago yung klase and you'll be excused. Okay? So, maliwanag po sana tayo doon with how you attend and how you communicate with me to your problems. So, wala namang problema sa akin na mali. Problema sa akin umabsent, basta magpaalam. In the absence of asking for permission, hindi po yan tatanggapin. We leave today's class. Let's have a short activity muna. Let me just bring up one of the things na binanggit ko sa orientation is take notes and listen. Okay? Itong grade nyo dito would be part of, so kukolektahin natin dyan and eventually I would put it as part of your attendance. So let me. We'll have our next lesson. Then after next week, next week, pangatlong meeting lesson natin, we will already be having your first lab exercise. So, i-introduce ko na sa inyo yung gagamitin nating website to actually be able to what do we call this program and simulate movement of. So let me just share this real quick, guys. Okay, ayan po. So 1450063 sa mga bagong students ko, just go to kahoot.it. Punta lang kayo sa browser nyo. Go to kahoot.it. May lalabas to, hihingin yung game pin, palagay 1450063. Kung naka-smartphone kayo, hindi nyo na kailangan i-download yung app. Bukas lang kayo ng browser, then palagay lang po yung ano ninyo. Then, ihingin po yung pangalan ninyo, ang ilagay po apelido. Okay, last name po ang ilagay kasi ina-record ko po yung grades. Mahihirapan akong mag alphabeticalize niyan kung ang apelyido ninyo ay hindi naka-arrange alphabetically. So, kung may kapelyido kayo dito sa klase or first initial, first name initial. So, I'll give you 2 minutes para makapasok po and then you would be begin or we would begin na shortly. So we're expecting, so this is my way of checking your listening skills and focus during the discussion. At mauhuli din natin dito yung mga tipong log in and run. Okay? Na-log in, then aalis na, maglalaro na at kung ano-ano ang gagawin. Okay. Sige lang, Ms. Alarcon, we'll wait for you. Mag-reconnect lang si Ms. Alarcon. So I'm expecting around 50 participants to come in. We have 42. We're just going to wait for Ms. Alarcon. Ayan, nandiyan na si Ms. Alarcon. Diyan lang po kayo sa may tahot.it mag-i-stay. Okay? So, 30 seconds left before we begin. Okay, sige, nagpapahintay din si Clarence. We'll wait for Clarence. Ayan, nandiyan na si Clarence, nakapasok na. So, let us begin. As always, each question is 20 seconds long. Fastest finger wins. So, kung nag-aabang ka ng biyaya at nahuli ka na sa pagsagot, mababa lang rin yung points na makukuha mo. So, pabilisan po ito. Hindi para may kaso rin kasi na mas konti yung tama, mas mataas pa dun sa perfect kasi mabagal din magsagot. Let us begin. Robotics lesson 1. First question. So this is the world's first full-scale humanoid intelligent robot. So most of you got the correct answer. It is Wabot 1. Let's look at the 5 fastest fingers natin. So we have Susan. Gabuhok lang ang lamang niya kay Corpus. Followed by Romero. And sabay na nagpasok ng answer si Lanuevo and Reyes. Question number 2. Blank was a precursor to the industrial robotic arm found in modern factories. Okay, most of you got the correct answer. It is the claw. Tingnan natin. So, Susan is still the highest, followed by Rioner, then Abatay, na pantay si Lanuevo and Masangkay. Lumakang is the highest climber, up 9 place. Good job. Question number 3. This is the first mobile robot capable of reasoning about its surroundings. Pinakaunang mobile robot daw. So the correct answer is Shaky. Most of you got the correct answer. Let's take a look. Oy, may bago na tayong number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, umangat po si Romero followed by De Leon, Corpus, Ablasa, followed by Kevin Susan. Up 9 places is Mendaño. Question number 4. So, what law or anong number ng law ito? A robot may not harm humanity or by inaction allow humanity to come to harm. Okay, so the correct answer is the zeroth law of robotics. Humanity po yung nakalagay rito. Ang first law of robotics, which most of you answered, is a robot may not harm humans or by inaction allow humans to come to harm. Ah, medyo nalito po tayo sa question na to. So, first five na natin ngayon, medyo nabago. We now have Alavanzas, Susan, Ablaza, Rioner, and Munda. Panganiban is the highest climber, up 13 places. Last question for the podium. Question number 5. Robota is Czechoslovakian for blank. Okay, most of you got the correct answer. It is the worker. Let's look at our top 5. Bronze medalist natin, second runner-up, is Ablaza with 4-7. For 7-36, we have Alavanzas. And gold medalist natin for 7-59 is Susan Kevin. So nabawi po ni Kevin yung kanyang nawalis. And fourth and fifth, we have Rioner and Arenal. So congratulations to everyone. Nagka-problem lang tayo with one question. So this is the zeroth law po ha. Paalala lang po. So thank you very much everyone. We would be ending today's lesson. Pahintay na lang po nung activities natin for today. And pakisagutan na lang po. Yung essay po, hanggang ngayon lang po yan pwedeng sagutan hanggang bago mag-midnight. Yung midterm quiz 1 natin about the orientation, anytime pwedeng sagutan po. So thank you very much. Hopefully marami po tayo natutunan. Kita na lang po tayo next week for the continuation to our second lesson. Have a great lunch, guys, and bye-bye.
Thank you, Bruce, sir.
Thank you, Bruce, sir.